So 6 p.m. Friday is when the free agency new league year window opens up, correct? That's the next step right now?
Yes, that's okay. That's the next one.
All right. Now, who's the first to go here? What do we expect just over the horizon now that everything's jam-packed and compacted, drafted?
It's going to be frantic, that's for sure.
Right.
I mean, this has all been wild. It's not the most robust free agent market.
Mm-hmm.
Next summer is the summer people are targeting largely because there's, at least for now, Giannis is scheduled to be a part of it. And there are a number of teams that are trying to keep their powder dry for that summer so they can have some flexibility, Miami being chief among them. One of the more intriguing players on the market is probably Fred VanVleet from Toronto. I mean, he is coming off another great season with the Raptors, won a championship. There will be a market maybe in Detroit or New York for him. The Raptors want to bring him back, but that's a $20 million per year salary that you're talking about. And you've got to be sure that Fred VanVleet is your guy. But he's probably, I would say, the most intriguing name on the free agent market. Everything else, Rich, is tied to the trade market. And what exactly the Houston Rockets decide to do in the next few weeks or even few months with James Harden. I mean, that's the guy. I mean, everyone from Brooklyn to maybe even Golden State to some others are going to be angling to be in the James Harden sweepstakes if the Rockets really start to push him on the open market. And, they're the team that could reshape the NBA with some of the deals that they make.
That was my next question, is what's going on there? Because, Harden has said he wants to go to the Nets, according to all reports. And usually what a star player wants, a star player gets, and he's a star player. The Warriors in the mix, is that in response to Clay? Or, I mean, where did that one come from, Chris?
Well, I mean, I kind of talked about this a year ago when, the Rockets had, they had plateaued a little bit. The season didn't end with Chris Paul the way they wanted it to. And the Warriors, because of that draft pick and because they have a very lightly protected first-round pick from Minnesota next year, they're a player for any team that's looking to get a haul of assets. And while they don't have the blue chip player to offer, like say a Brooklyn does, if you can get, James Wiseman, who is potentially a superstar, if you can get that draft pick and you're willing to take on Andrew Wiggins, who, is still a decent player, albeit an overpaid one, they can be in play. And look, one thing that's obvious about James Harden, this is what I tried to tell people a year ago, like James Harden is an alpha in Houston, but he's far more concerned about winning at this stage of his career than he is being the scoring champion for the fourth year in a row. I mean, he's accomplished a lot individually. And now, as he hits his early 30s, from what I'm always told, he's looking to win. That's why he's willing to go to Brooklyn and sacrifice to play alongside Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving. I think he's willing to go other places, like at Golden State, and sacrifice to play alongside star players. He's looking for an opportunity to win, and there's only a handful of teams that can really offer.
What about, lastly, I guess, a team that I mentioned quite a bit at the top of the show because I thought they had a dynamic night, and I love Daryl Morey. I mean, what a night he had last night. What about that idea? I'm reading in Philadelphia Inquirer that Meek Mill is reaching out to Harden to say, why don't you come here? But wouldn't that blow everything up the way that things are kind of set up for Morey? I mean, what about that possibility?
Well, Daryl Morey loves James Harden.
Yeah.
There's no doubt about that. And Philadelphia is one of the possible destinations for Harden if the Rockets get aggressive, which, to be clear, right now, they're not in any rush, nor should they be. I mean, Harden has two guaranteed years left in his contract, a third-year option that's worth like $50 million. So, he's tied into the Rockets one way or the other. So Houston, rightfully, their position right now is, what's the rush? If we do decide to deal James Harden, we want a bidding war. And that bidding war might not materialize until midseason when teams start to figure out what they are and what they need. And they want some desperate teams out there to make a run at a guy like Harden. Philadelphia is interesting, but Philadelphia, to get Harden, you'd have to throw in Ben Simmons. It's as simple as that.
Yeah.
Like it's you don't get James Harden without including Ben Simmons. And like, I'm not saying that's not something the Sixers would do. It certainly, I think, would be something worth considering, but I don't think they're there yet. I don't think they're the strongest team in the hunt for James Harden unless they're willing to put all their chips in with draft picks and young players to go get Harden, because other teams like Brooklyn and like some others are going to be willing to do that.